Well, what is going on, everybody? This is like week four of me being out on this job, and today we decided that we're gonna go to Nebraska and do the Nebraska route by ourselves. So here we are. We got the loud reefer on, so I'm sorry about that. Can't help that. But yeah, we are stopped over here, and I will tell you why. So we are building up our air pressure, because if you didn't see, my airline broke underneath the trailer. So I had no trailer brakes. So it was kind of difficult to get stopped coming up here to Lincoln, Nebraska. But I stopped at my fourth delivery and looked under there, noticed it, had to call Penske Roadside. And yeah, he's got it fixed right now. He's just kind of tucking them back away and buttoning things up. Thankfully, it was a quick dispatch. He got out here really quickly. You know, I could have been waiting out here for a couple hours. Did not want to do that, but I'm extremely behind, and it's, I guess that's trucking. As I say on Riding with Dave's channel, that's trucking. So that's what we got to deal with. So let me tell you all about today. It is Monday, and as you guys know, I am pretty brand new to this. I haven't completely been out on a route by myself yet. So, you know, I'm up in Nebraska, and I've ran the Nebraska route twice with the guy that was training me, and, you know, it really wasn't too bad. So I'm expecting, you know what, you know, it'll probably be a little bit slower, just me by, you know, one person. And, you know, at least I know all of the, you know, all the stops and have pretty much experienced it with somebody else. But no, man, it's been a Monday. First off, pretty much everything on the trailer, it's a 48-foot trailer. It was filled completely front to back, and I haven't even really made a dent in it today. Started at 2 a.m. I tried to start at 2 a.m. It was pretty stormy and raining a lot, so it took me a while to pre-trip and get all my stuff sorted out, and I didn't leave until, you know, closer to 3, 2:45, 3. And the trailer tandems weren't slid back to where I needed them to be for the weight. It was 36,000 pounds. They were up at the front. They really needed to be more towards the back. So, like, you know, ninth hole, tenth, you know, eighth hole, whatever. That was giving me issues. So I went to slide those this morning. I finally got it done, but giving me all sorts of issues. But little did I know, when I slid them in the dark, I drove all the way to Lincoln, Nebraska, and, you know, the whole time I'm like, you know what, it's, truck's not stopping very well. It's, you know, it's kind of odd. It doesn't feel like normal, but, you know, I'm in a different truck, you know, it's a different trailer. Could be all sorts of different factors that are, you know, weighing in on this. But I get to my first stop in Lincoln, it's a Fazoli's, and I just happened to look under the trailer, busted airline. So that's what you guys saw. It was an airline that just got torn in half when I slid those tandems. And I guess after everything was all said and done, the airlines really weren't, the spring hangers weren't in the locations they should have been. And, you know, everything needed reorganized, and which he did. So it was a long while for sure. I would have liked to be in Omaha, but I've got to go 90 miles west to Grand Island, Nebraska, which is different. We didn't do that ever when we were doing this route for training. So yeah, it's kind of a haul. It's an hour and a half, hour and a half drive from here. And so I'm gonna, I guess, leave at 2 a.m. I'm in the hotel. I've been in the hotel since 4:08, 4 o'clock, something like that, to start my 10-hour break. So I'm gonna leave at, you know, 2:15 in the morning and head out there. But yeah, it's been a stressful day. I mean, I thought that Friday, the last video that you guys saw where that drop and hook wasn't really working out, was kind of stressful, but nothing like today. But you just have to remember, just gotta take your time, you know, go slow. We're going to start out, you know, 2 a.m., head over there and come back to Lincoln, finish up Lincoln, go to Omaha, do Omaha. And then I got to go to Fort Dodge, Iowa, to pick up a backhaul that's going back to Springfield. So it's got to be a full couple of days for sure. You know, we will see what happens tomorrow. Okay, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is, what, 2:14,
and we are on duty logging our pre-trip inspection. Yeah, here we are, 2 a.m. The reason being is we got so behind yesterday from the trailer thing that I've got to start really, really early just to try to get caught up. So yeah, I mean, that's the name of the game sometime. Typically on the second day, we wouldn't have to start until about 5 o'clock. We got to jump over, drive an hour and a half immediately over to Grand Island, Nebraska, and kick off a wing stop there. Come back here to Lincoln, finish up my stops in Lincoln, then go to Omaha. So hopefully we're in for a better day today than I was yesterday. It's pretty hectic, but just got to remember not to get stressed and, you know, not to let everything get to you, just because that's what happens sometimes. Just nothing you can do about it. But yeah, even the hotel guy, the receptionist was like, man, it's early. So yep, it sure is. And you're always gonna have, sometimes you'll have some kind of issues, but I don't know, just how it goes. Especially when you drive these trucks, try to really just get things going, get things done. That's all we could do. And check our fifth wheel, make sure somebody didn't decide to pull that overnight, and it looks good. Okay. Low air. Yeah, I would imagine so. That would probably make sense. Conditioning doesn't work in this truck very well, so that's one of the main reasons I'm not looking forward to the 90 degree weather today. So yeah, got that going for us. Just one more minute left and we should be good to go. We've got 423 miles on the clock so far and plenty more drives. So let's go ahead and get at it. It is an hour and a half drive, maybe a little bit longer, just being in the trucks a little bit slower, and I think it was like 89 or 90 miles that direction one way, so a little bit out of sequence compared to, I think, how it was supposed to be. I guess it's a new stop that kind of got tossed on the route, and a brand new wing stop, so they just opened it, or getting ready to open it. So I'd be the first person to put anything in there. So that was kind of cool, but man, it was, it's a big chunk of time. It's probably, you give it an hour and a half to drive, about an hour to unload, an hour and a half back. So you're looking at easy 4 hours out of the day gone. So that was just putting me even further and further behind. Obviously, we didn't need any more setbacks during the time, because it was, really going against me as far as, making the deliveries at the normal time. My drive time for that day. So I definitely knew that I was probably not going to make it back when I was supposed to. This specific route is a 3-day route. Usually we can get it done in 2 days and start heading back to Springfield, but there's definitely going to be a little bit more time involved on this one. Alright, so we're going to jump ahead a few hours, making the rest of our deliveries in Lincoln. All that's done. and that wing stop that was in Grand Island, everything that's all finished up and behind us now. So we finished up in Lincoln, and now we're on our way to Omaha. So we've got to drive over to Omaha, which about, I think it was 45 minutes away from Lincoln. So it's not too far away, but still, you know, that's drive time. And we've got some drops to make in Omaha before we could head to Iowa to pick up that backhaul. But the thing about the backhaul is it took so much extra time to go to the Grand Island stop that I called him and said, hey, there's not going to be any way that I'm going to be able to make this backhaul pickup, especially because it's a live load, so you're still going to have to wait for it. And Fort Dodge is 3 hours and some change away from Omaha, so there's definitely no way. So what ended up happening is we were going to send somebody else up there to get it, and kind of took that off of me. So at least there was that, but still, just everything that went on the past couple days was extremely stressful, and definitely made for the route to be a lot longer than it was supposed to. Hotel in Omaha. Once again, we've only got, well, it says 5 minutes left of drive time now, but I arrived with 9 minutes left of drive time, and it has been an absolutely insane day. So I'll have to go upstairs in the hotel room, do the paperwork, and figure out what time I need to get started in the morning, and you know, plan from there. Now, we were supposed to do a pickup in Fort Dodge, Iowa. But I guess he's going to send up another truck to do that and take that off of my load. That way I could just go back to Springfield. That way Thursday I can go back to St. Louis, overnight St. Louis, Thursday night, come back on Friday, and hopefully enjoy the weekend. So lots to do and very little time to do it. We are very, very busy this week. Well, there she is down there. The old 2015 Freightliner and all her glory all parked up. I always angle it out just so I know I can get out in the morning. Park at the end, angle out. That way I know I can get out and I'm not going to be blocked in. But guys, I think I'm going to wrap up the video here. Tomorrow, all we're going to do is actually, we're not going to pick up. I don't know if I mentioned it. We're not going to pick up that backhaul in Iowa. We're going to finish up here in Omaha tomorrow, then come back home. And that's really all that's going on. So unless something really interesting happens that I need to pick up the camera for, I'm just gonna call it good for this trip, my first trip out on my own to Omaha, Nebraska. But I had a few questions and comments that I would like to address on my past couple of videos, or my past video. I have a few people asking how it is being out here and doing this job as a type 1 diabetic. You know, how's it affecting me? You know, how am, you know, I kind of coping with it and adjusting to it? Well, this job in particular, very physical. So what I'll do is on my insulin pump, I'll actually set it to not give me as much insulin during the day for the time that I'm going to be working. So I'll decrease it down 50%, and that way it only gives me 50% insulin for the day. That way I don't have a ton of low blood sugars. Of course, you'll use your meter, check your blood sugar. You know, if you got a Dexcom, which I do, but I haven't been wearing it because I didn't want it to get ripped off. That'll be, you know, something you could use as well. Keep a lot of snacks. You know, I get the big size fudge rounds or the big size oatmeal cream pies. I usually keep 2 bottles or so of glucose tablets, the big bottles, you know, juice. You know, in the morning I'll start out with like an orange juice or a chocolate milk to kind of get ready, especially when I've got a delivery that's, you know, 5 minutes down the road and I don't want my sugar to go low. But, you know, other than that, I feel pretty good as far as physically. My blood sugars have kind of, they've been lower. They've really been running lower. And, you know, it's probably for the best, but that's what I do with it. As far as like driving and stuff goes, I never really have a problem with it. Just before I go out, you know, on a longer drive, just make sure
that your blood sugar is at a good level. It's not dropping. It's not going to go low. Stuff like that. You just want to watch out for that kind of stuff. But other than that, it's pretty easy. Anyway, for those of you who are going to be joining PFG, congratulations. I hope you enjoy the job. It's definitely something different. So, you know, just know that. But I did get my first paycheck, non-training paycheck. It's coming up on Friday. Already know what it is. It's definitely so much better than any of my other paychecks before. So that is 100% a positive. But we will see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for stopping in, clicking that play button. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel if you're not already. I've got plenty more stuff along the way, plenty more trips. I don't know. Who knows where we're going to go next. But if it's anything interesting, we'll make sure that we film it. So take care, guys. Have a good one. So I was just trying to go to bed and check this out. Got some nice skies over there, but we're getting surrounded by this pretty nasty looking storm. It's coming in as like a tornado warning on the weather stations. So yeah, it's getting pretty windy. Of course, it's always windy up here. But this is what we're looking at. I don't know if you could tell, but I'm right here. That storm's moving in over here from the west. And I was just in bed trying to go to sleep, and the phone went crazy. So I figured I'd come out here, film it, see what's going on. Probably just go back inside, go back to sleep. I don't think there's anything too major, but the sky's just very strange.